We asked, in patients who are known to have cardiac sarcoid, how often is the cardiac PET positive while the MRI is negative? So we had about 150 patients with cardiac sarcoid, and of those, about 15% had an abnormal PET, but a normal MRI. So that really emphasizes the value of cardiac PET in addition to MRI for diagnosing these patients. What we think is that cardiac PET could be better for patients who present early in the disease in the acute phase, because what we found is in some of these patients who go on to have a subsequent MRI, then it is abnormal. So the cardiac PET may be abnormal early in the disease before the MRI is abnormal, and that can be really important to know for these patients to direct them to the appropriate therapy. The second abstract we had today looked at our national registry in patients with recurrent pericarditis. So this is the residence registry of patients with recurrent pericarditis. And what we're interested in is to know what's the use of interleukin-1 blockers in patients with recurrent pericarditis. We know that these are highly effective therapies in certain patients from our clinical trials. But the question is, what's going on in the real world? So in this US registry of over 200 patients, we found that about half were on interleukin-1 blockers. The important question is, in those patients are on interleukin-1 blockers, are they being used appropriately? And what do we mean by that? Well, if a patient's chronically on steroids, that's not a good thing. So those patients should be on an interleukin blocker. Or if a patient has disease that's refractory to NSAIDs and colchicine, and we think they're gonna need a long course of treatment, they should be on an interleukin blocker as opposed to starting corticosteroids. So if we looked specifically at those patients in this registry who were on interleukin-1 blockers, it looked appropriate. About half the patients were being started on therapy to be able to wean off of corticosteroids, so those corticosteroid-dependent patients. And the other half were on NSAIDs and colchicine and were started on interleukin-1 blocker, obviating the need for corticosteroids. And so I think what this really represents is real-world application of effective treatments that we know from our clinical trials.